In a statement presented to Parliament by the Minister of State for Transport, Fred Byamukama, on the status of the Kampala-Jinja Expressway, the project will be undertaken as a public-private partnership. The developer will mobilize private financing towards the implementation of the project, which they will recover over a 25-year operation and maintenance period.
The Kampala-Jinja Express is to be undertaken as a public-private partnership project in accordance with the PPP Act 2015. The developer will need to mobilize private financing towards the implementation of the project, which they will recover over a 25-year operation and maintenance period. All the bidders participating in the procurement have raised bankability issues that affect the ability to commit private financing to the project. This includes a partial risk guarantee covering annual payment that will be made to the developer.
The minister apprised Parliament that the land required for 45 kilometers has been acquired, including 14 kilometers along the southern bypass and 31 kilometers along the Kampala-Jinja main line. He told Parliament that the government will require 2 more years to acquire the full section of right-of-way needed for the entire project.
This includes 14 kilometers along the southern bypass and 31 kilometers along the Kampala-Jinja main line. The progress of compensation has been slowed down by lack of funds to effect payments. By December 2024, this very year, the government targets to have acquired the full section from Kampala to Namagunga and the whole Kampala Southern Bypass. The rest of the land from Namagunga to Jinja is planned to be acquired by December 2025.
The Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayebwa, who was not pleased by the statement, slammed bureaucratic procurement procedures that cause unnecessary delays in implementing national strategic projects. Tayebwa wondered why the procurement process for the construction of the Kampala-Jinja Expressway has taken more than 5 years, a development he said is already costing the taxpayers money.
Really? I remember you had, I was told you had reached on around 4 farms and you were about to close. Why should procurement take 5 years? And which projection are you going to use? You yourself here just a short while ago, you told us on Kanungu, Rukunjiri Kanungu Road, you told us when a bag of cement was being sold at around 20,000, now it's at around 30,000. So all these costs, who will cover them?
Parliament has not adopted the statement. It sent it back and asked the minister to collect information and appraise Parliament on the status of all roads across the country.
Of one of the meetings in the second session, this House had directed the Minister of Works and Transport to bring a full and detailed statement on the status of all the roads in this country for discussion, detailing when it was last worked on, the ones they are going to work on now, what type of work they are going to do on it, the criteria being used, and to the exclusion of other parts of this country, using those small justifications, this one. Next time we might hear about wetland roads and etc.
That indeed, nearly every day, one of you is coming to office, to my office, over roads. They are the most dominating issues. So, Honourable Minister, you are just required to update this statement. If you could, then we can have one Thursday when we are handling members' issues. We say this Thursday we are handling one item.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.